This is money in the city's Children and Youth Fund, the new Children and Youth Fund. It is funded with tax dollars. A year ago, the first round of $12 million was being dispersed to more than 80 organizations. This year's allocations are being pushed into next year. The new Children and Youth Fund in Baltimore was popular with voters and approved in the 2016 election. It devotes $12 million to children and youth programs in the city's annual budget. From last year's budget, more than 80 organizations were awarded grants. This year, no applications are even being accepted, even though a new pot of $12 million is in the city's current budget. Consultant Davon Love says the ransomware attack and the Catherine Pugh investigation have delayed the ability of the fund to manage new applications. The fund's grants are under audit, the scrutiny all the more intense because the fund's fiscal agent, Associated Black Charities, bought Healthy Holly children's books.
It'll show that there was no relationship between the mayor's dealings and the youth fund. But because of the increased scrutiny, because the way it's been drug in, it's created a dynamic that it's really just increased the burden of work.
The intent of the fund was to operate outside city government and to get more money to community-based organizations. A small team manages the fund's operations.
They have been sucked away to have to deal with the audit, which has gotten in the way of our ability to execute on a plan to get out dollars more quickly.
The needs of youth remain front and center. Last night in the Otterbein community, the police commissioner heard complaints about squeegee kids. He answered he's looking for alternatives to arrest unless actual crimes are committed.
We're seeing officers going out arresting them for the ones that are being violent and the ones that are committing right. other crimes.
Given the climate that we're in, that there's kind of, a real urgency to make sure that dollars get out. Our hope is that eventually we can move to a cycle where it's not just a yearly cycle.
Davon Love hopes that applications will be accepted early next year for the next round of funding. He also wants a permanent oversight entity to take the place of Associated Black Charities as the fiscal agent. In the new budget for 2020, the one that starts July 1, another $12 million, actually $13 million for that year, will be allocated to the fund. Reporting live from downtown, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.